Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to my channel once again. So, Charlie, today, as you have seen in the title, it's very simple. I'm asking a very, very, very simple question. That is Ghana really? Do you think Ghana is peaceful? You know, sometimes you hear certain stuff from the country Ghana and you ask yourself, is this the peaceful country they talk about? But one thing that you should know is that bad news happens everywhere in this world and in every country. It's a normal thing. So you shouldn't be surprised. But today I am here to let you know whether Ghana is peaceful or not. So just stay tuned and keep your fingers crossed. I'm here to give you some series of videos and explain certain things to you for you to understand whether Ghana is peaceful or not. You'll judge it by yourself. But for now, I just want to give you some few clips that some people who have come to Ghana and experienced Ghana are saying about Ghana. So just take a look.
But Ghana is like one of the safest places on this planet Earth. Especially, I think it's like rated number one, not of the world, but of Africa, is like the safest country. They have a great relationship with America and some of the other, you know, big time countries. And so they're a very peaceful country. Very, very nice people, very humble. And so there's not a lot of danger.
To Ghana.
Why Ghana?
Because like that's the only place I have like actual genuine peace, man.
Okay.
You get me? It's like when you go to like Labadi Beach. And then you're looking in the water, man. And then, like, you see there's this line at the end where it's, like, it separates the sky from the water.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's where God lives.
They're just so friendly and so kind and so sweet all the time. It takes a lot to make a Ghanaian mad. And even when they're mad, they're not rash. Like I said, they're not violent or anything, and it just passes and everything's going to be okay after that. So that's really sweet. They yell a lot, but they don't ever fight, and that's okay with them. Even their language is pretty aggressive. And so when I first got there, I remember thinking everyone was yelling at each other. And I remember asking my companion, like, why is everybody shouting at each other? And he's like, oh, they're not shouting. That's just the way they talk. I personally felt really safe all of the time, even after dark. Ghanaians are so nonviolent. They're the only West African country who hasn't had civil war since they've gained independence.
You know, Ghana's my second home.
Yeah, I know, but I want to know which.
Shout out to house in Ghana.
Whereabouts?
I'm not telling you. I don't need to tell you.
I want to visit.
No, I don't trust you. Go to Ghana. My friend's wife. She makes this crazy Ghana jollof.
Wow.
With some goat meat. It's bad. So, I love Ghana jollof.
So they're just super friendly people, super friendly. Like one of the things I found out very quickly at the beginning of my mission is it's actually an insult to not say hello to somebody, which is way different than American culture where we just ignore each other walking down the road. They'd look at me and they'd just be like, you didn't say hi to me. I'd be like, oh, hi. Be like, oh, thank you. What's your name? And then they just introduce themselves. They're just a very friendly people that just wants to be around people.
Respect people. So I've just arrived in the airport in Accra, in Ghana, one of the most progressive African countries. And a lot of people wouldn't think that this is an airport in Africa, but it is. You should come and visit. And this is the entrance to a beautiful experience. Ghana has not very much violence. It has amazing fruits and foods. It has amazing sights to see. There's many, many beautiful people. The nightlife here is amazing. And if you are thinking about coming to Africa and you need a first experience country, this country should be the first experience country. It's beautiful. I don't know what else to say. I'm just happy to be here. Shout out to all of the people from Ghana. Shout out to all of the Pan-Africans. Shout out to all the people who are going to travel here. Come and buy land, raise your families here, move here, and get out of the West, because I'm hearing it's cold there. Mad thing.
So you see, that is what I'm talking about. This is the testimonies of some people who have visited Ghana and have experienced Ghana. You understand? So, I don't want to talk much. Let's get straight into the video. One, what am I talking about? You know, in every country, anywhere in the world, mostly, what actually causes civil war in every country in the world? I have given myself three major things that causes civil war in every country. So, I want to just give you the three and also do what? Break down these three major points that I'm giving you. One is politics. We all know politics has actually spoiled and damaged or caused so many lives to be lost in so many countries. Another thing is what? Religion. It has actually caused a lot of people. And my last point is tribalism. So, my first point, politics. When you come to Ghana and you switch on your TV and you are watching television, especially in the morning, when these politicians are doing their argument here and there, talking and shouting at each other and all these things, let me tell you, these politicians that you see, hardly will you see them throw punches at each other. It is very hard. Unlike some other countries, you might see something like that, but it's very difficult in Ghana to see something like that. It is very, very, very difficult. And even when they finish this TV shows, I'm telling you, you see them behind closed doors or even in town, just talking to each other and eating together and doing all sorts of things together. That's how the Ghanaian politicians are. And sometimes on TV, you hear them saying, my brother on the other side, my brother on the other side, my brother on the other side. That's how Ghanaian politicians talk. Let me give you a simple example. There are two brothers, they are actually siblings, who are into Ghanaian politics. Same mother, same father. But these two politicians, one is in the NDC and the other is in the MPP. And my question that I want to ask you is, do you think these people will ever fight? They are from the same family, same mother, same father. My question is, do you think these people will ever fight? Most of these politicians have been classmates. They are friends, they are schoolmates, they are course mates. So I always say it is very difficult for you to see something happen, a misunderstanding or something that can escalate to the point that nobody can control it. It doesn't happen. In 2017, when Nana Akufo-Addo became president, he invited all our living former heads of state to, and he had a meeting with them for over 2 hours. My question is, how many countries can this happen there? How many?
The meeting, which lasted for about 2 hours, was between President Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo and former President Jerry John Rawlings, John Ejekum Kufuor, and John Dramani Mahama. First to arrive at the presidency was former President Jerry John Rawlings, who was met on arrival by the Chief of Staff, Frema Osei Opari, and Director of State Protocol, Ambassador Hassan Ahmad, and then received by President Akufo-Addo at his office. Next was former President John Ejekum Kufuor, who was also met on arrival by the Chief of Staff, Frema Osei Opari, and Deputy Chief of Staff, Abu Jinapor, and then received by President Akufo-Addo at his office. He was followed by former President John Dramani Mahama, who was also met on arrival by the Chief of Staff, Frema Osei Opari, Deputy Chief of Staff, Abu Jinapo, and Director of State Protocol, Ambassador Hassan Ahmad, and then received by President Akufo-Addo at his office. The meeting, which lasted for 2 hours, was held in good atmosphere, one of frank exchanges and mutual respect.
President Nana Akufo-Addo, President Kufuor, John Jerry Rawlings, may his soul rest in peace, and John Dramani Mahama. They had a meeting for over 2 hours. Every country is not perfect, but the rate at which bad things happen in that country determines how bad or the level of peace that that country has. So some people say Ghana is not peaceful and all that, Charlie. This is my country, and I'm telling you, Ghana is peaceful. And people who have traveled to this country will attest to the fact that this country is peaceful. If you think I'm lying, just comment below. Just comment below. I have a video to show you, and that video has two politicians from the two strongest political parties that we have in Ghana going on TV, national television, and they played a game, and I'm telling you how fun that game was. This is Ghana. Let's see the video.
Thank you.
You see, me, I listen to songs with my youth. Okay. I don't do cobalotes.
So you see, as I told you, this is the country we live in. Let me move to my next point. The religious differences. Religious differences. Someone will say I'm a Muslim, someone will say I'm a Christian. When you come to Ghana, it is very difficult for you to even know who is a Muslim, who is a Christian. It is very, very, very difficult. Unless you see them dress or mention their name to you before you would know this person is a Christian. But I'm telling you, we have about 30% Muslims in Ghana. They have communities all over Ghana, not just one place. They are everywhere. They are in Accra, they are in the central region, the eastern region, the Ashanti region, everywhere they are there. I'm telling you, Muslims in Ghana are the coolest ever. Muslims in Ghana are the coolest in the world. Why am I saying all this? Let me tell you a story. A pastor in Ghana once prophesied that the Muslim chief imam, senior most chief imam, in national chief imam, I mean national chief imam, will die. I think it was in 2019 or something. And some few Muslim youth were angry. They went to the church to vandalize some of the church staffs. But I'm telling you, the moment the chief imam spoke and said, please, no one should go to the church and do what? Vandalize anything there, like there again. None of the Muslim youth went there to destroy anything from that day. And I think the pastor also realized how he prophesied wasn't the right way. So he also did what? Went to the chief imam's palace just to do what? Just to apologize. And I'm telling you, everything became very cool. They all understood each other and everybody went their ways.
Hand in hand, Sheikh Dr. Osmanu Nuhu Shaributu and Reverend Owusu Bempah walked in. The demeanor of both religious leaders communicated nothing but peace and love. The Reverend presented a cow to show appreciation to the chief imam. He said, but for his swift intervention, issues would have been worse.
That man, I'm telling you, in the next year or so, he celebrated his 100th birthday. That man celebrated his 100th birthday. And I'm telling you, he went to the church. That chief imam that I'm talking about went to the church to celebrate his 100th birthday with the church. Just imagine how peaceful that man is. In Ghana, Ghana is the only country that I have heard, or perhaps I am from here, so I'm speaking about my experience. Ghana is the only country that you will hear or see Muslims celebrating their Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha, and Christians will celebrate with them. And in the same vein, you see Christians celebrating their Christmas and Easter festivities, and you will see Muslims celebrating with them. That is the country I'm from, Ghana. I don't know the criteria that they mostly do what use in selecting countries to be the peaceful country in the world by these Global Peace Index people. But I am telling you, Ghana is peaceful. Let me move to my next and my last point. Ethnic differences. Ethnic differences or tribal differences that we have in Ghana. Let me tell you, Ghana is the only country that I know that, Charlie, we have actually intermarried ourselves to the extent that I can tell you about 60% of Ghanaians have married from different tribes. Efanti will marry an Ewe. An Ewe will marry a Gan. A Gan will marry an Ashanti. Like, it's so many. Like, every Ghanaian, if you are Ghanaian and you are watching this, you can attest to the fact that, Charlie, we have actually intermarried ourselves to the extent that, Charlie, you can't even know. You see, out of 10 Ghanaians now, out of 10 Ghanaians, I'm telling you, about 7 will tell you that my mom is Ghan, my father is Ashanti. My mom is Fanti, my dad is Ewe. It's a lot. A lot. That is Ghana for you. Let me give you a typical example. Our former president, John Jerry Rawlings, may his soul rest in perfect peace, married an Ashanti, and he is from the Ewe tribe. And let me tell you, we consider that marriage in Ghana as one of the best marriages to ever happen in this country. That man, I'm telling you, saw, or both of them, the wife and the man himself, met at a very young age when they were in school. I think primary school or something. And they had been together, struggled together till the time this man became president. Like, they've been together since. It's just 2020 that John Jerry Rawlings passed away. And I'm saying just death, or only death, separated them. They've been together for a very long time. So this is a very typical example that I'm giving you. That is how we are in Ghana. So I am telling you, Ghana is very, very peaceful. If you are a diaspora from any part of this world and you want to visit Ghana, or you want to visit Africa, Ghana is the best place for you. You can even check online and you will get so many information about this country, and I'm telling you, it is the best place that you can ever be. Ghana is peaceful. And we want this to go to the end of the world. We don't want to hear any civil war anywhere in this country. That's one thing that we pray for. I thank you so much for watching this video. I thank you, and I thank you again and again and again. Everything that you do for me, supporting me and supporting my channel, I thank you, and I'll be bringing you great videos like this more and more. I'm very sure today you are seeing a different setup. And my question is, how do you find this setup and the background and everything? If you like it, just comment below and let me know, so that I'll be bringing you this type of setup all the time. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, don't forget, and like the video. Bye-bye.